Declan Holmes is a 17-year-old from Batemans Bay, living life to the full, excelling at school and loving sport.
In my spare time, I enjoy playing rugby union for my local club, the Browley Dolphins. I've always enjoyed playing sport and doing physical activity.
But in his early high school years, Declan found his legs were failing him.
But something always seemed to be not quite right. I didn't seem to have the same level of balance or strength as everyone else my age. This problem continued to exacerbate as I got older.
Endless visits to hospitals and doctors followed, but there were no answers.
My family had tried lots of things to help me with my movement over the years, and we'd talked to lots of medical practitioners and medical people about what might be causing the problem. Most people told us that I'll grow into my legs soon and it will improve as I get older and start strength training, but this never really happened.
A doctor sent Declan for an MRI and spots were found on the white matter of his brain. Declan was moved to the Children's Hospital at Westmead and diagnosed with unknown leukodystrophy, a condition that affects the brain, spinal cord and nerves and can lead to death.
And that was the original outlook, was that I was likely to pass away within the next sort of few months during my original diagnosis, which was really, really brutal for my family and friends and for myself.
But Declan's neurologist wasn't satisfied with the diagnosis, so enrolled him into the Australian Genomics Leukodystrophy Trial. The genetic experts searched his 22,000 genes and found Declan had an extremely rare condition. He was the first in Australia to be diagnosed with this new gene mutation.
The results were good because they gave my problem a name. It's called VPS13D, spinocerebellar ataxia. This is obviously named after the gene, as that's not a very catchy title.
Not a catchy title, but Declan's prognosis is not fatal. Now he's focused on getting on with life, being a teenager and managing his condition.
Without the genetic testing, we would not have known this. Because his imaging, his MRI scans of his brain do look like a leukodystrophy. It's the genetic testing that's clarified things and given his family and his doctors certainty of what he's got.
Australian Genomics has helped thousands of people like Declan through its 21 flagship research programs. By searching through the body's DNA, our genetic code, Australian Genomics has been able to identify, sometimes within days, diseases that have baffled other medical experts for years. And all that's usually needed are blood samples. The need for a swift diagnosis is never more urgent than when a child or baby is in intensive care. Another Australian genomics program, the acute care study, is giving the sickest children access to fast turnaround genomic testing. These tests aim to pinpoint the source of the problem in the body's DNA. And results can be delivered in just days to worried parents.
Families are hugely distressed when they have a baby or a child admitted to hospital with critical illness, and there's a great period of uncertainty and anxiety. So we have been able to shorten that period considerably for many families.
A precious diagnosis explains why the child is sick. It enables the condition to be managed, treated, even cured, and it can also reveal the risk of future babies being born with the same problem. The acute care study is now being rolled out across Australia. And for the first time this year, some genetic tests have been listed with a Medicare benefit schedule, meaning costs running into thousands of dollars will be reimbursed for the families of children tested for childhood syndromes and intellectual disability.
And so now they are much more used to the concept of genomic testing and its potential implications in the rare disease space.
This is paving the way for more government subsidies of genetic testing, and parents couldn't be happier.
Genomic testing has cost-saving benefits to the healthcare system, but it also supports parents' mental health. When you finally get an answer, it's like a weight has been lifted from your shoulders.
A key advantage of genomic testing is that it can spare people with undiagnosed conditions a barrage of invasive tests like lumbar punctures, biopsies and countless blood tests.
And I think during that hospital test, I had every sort of test you can imagine. I had bloods, spinal, nerve conduction and more MRIs. The doctors and nurses were amazing and always tried to keep me smiling.
But no one wants to be on an endless quest for answers.
Genetic testing was easy compared to the other tests.
And an ever-growing number of hospitals and medical experts are now offering genomic testing. Australian Genomics is delivering answers to people who've been searching for years, bringing their diagnostic journey to an end.
It's been really beneficial for me to have access to this trial at Australian Genomics because it's helped bring peace of mind to me and my family and friends.